A lot of people have the impression that entertainers are alcoholics. You hear it all the time. As a matter of fact, we work in a local nightclub, and when we get through on the bandstand, people say, "Do you guys like a drink?" And of course, very politely, we say, "No, we don't drink." So immediately they assume we're dope addicts. Where the connection comes in, I don't know, but the worst thing I can ever recall doing was fanning each other in the showers with wet towels, going out with lewd women. As a matter of fact, the other night I came home and I said to my wife, I said, "Bruce, Bruce was a lovely girl. She had one bad habit. She'd go to movies and she'd see what happens in the movie and then she'd kind of act out the whole thing. Like, she saw this picture of The Lost Weekend with Ray Milland. She got to the point that when I'd buy a bottle of whiskey, she'd take it and tie a string around the neck and hang it out the window, and I'd have to pull it up and she'd hide it and I'd pull it up, and this would go on and on. She lived the role. I had a slight drinking problem, of course, but she sort of overemphasized it. She'd do sneaky little things, like she'd lie in my bed. She had her own bed. She'd lie in my bed, and she'd read Playboy magazines. She'd drink beer out of cans and throw the cans indiscriminately around the room, on the table, on the floor, on the chair, and it got so you couldn't tell one can from another. I got the impression that my wife was trying to kill me. I mean, just sneaky little things. And I thought, well, there's only one way to solve this problem. That would be to get rid of my wife first. I wouldn't use a knife or a gun or a rope because, this is ridiculous. Everybody kills their wives this way. I'd go down to the drugstore and I'd buy a jar of Vaseline. Do you know what I got the jar of Vaseline for?
No, what?
29 cents. And I took the jar of Vaseline and I walked into the bathroom because I knew my wife would have to go in there eventually. And I spread the whole jar around the seat. And I waited till my wife walked into the bathroom. And as she walked in, a very strange thing happened. She walked over towards it. I watched her through the keyhole. And as she sat down, she slipped through. I could hear her screams for help, help, help. Did I help her? No, I raced into the bathroom with a fiendish gleam in my eye. I reached down and I flushed the toilet. And down she went, whirling and swirling, whirling and swirling. 14 years of marriage down the drain. No more would I hear my wife's agonizing yells. No more would I hear her nagging. I could sleep at night. And as I lay in my bed, I heard noises emanating from the bathroom. The banging, the clanging, the banging. There was so much banging going on, I couldn't sleep. And one night when I could stand it no longer, I raced up to the bathroom door. And I took hammers, I took nails, I took mortar and cement. And I hammered up the bathroom door. I boarded up the door. I used chains, padlocks, cement. And I said to myself, I will never go to that bathroom again. But I was wrong. 2, 3, 4 days went by. I was a bachelor now. I had been eating what was in the cabinets, like all bran and prunes. A strange thing happened one day. I finally decided I would have to go in there. And as I raced up to the bathroom door, I reached up and with my bare hands, I tore down the mortar. I tore through the boards. I tore through the cement, the chains, the padlocks. And there it was, the same thing that had killed my wife. And I knew that I too would have to use it. And as I walked over towards it, I sat down. I could feel my wife's eyes staring up at me. I could feel her eyes staring up, up, up. I could hear her screams for help, help, help. She had me crying. my mind. She had me.